Raoult's law.
So what are the limitations of Raoult's law? Okay, tell me, the limitations of Raoult's law is exactly similar to limitations of Henry's law. Do you remember what are the limitations of Henry's law? First limitation. Yeah, Henry's law is applicable when? So soluble, whether gases are less soluble or more soluble? Gases are less soluble. Next, second limitation. It is not applicable at very high and very low temperature. Next, third application is, it is not applicable when solute, that is gas, either dissociate or associate. It is not applicable if the gas reacts with liquid solvent. So the same limitations we study here. First limitation is, limitation of Raoult's law is, this Raoult's law is, it is applicable for dilute solution. So what is the meaning of dilute solution? Solute should be less quantity or more quantity? Solute should be less quantity. Therefore, if the solute is less quantity, so this Raoult's law is applicable. Therefore, it is applicable at, that is in dilute solution having non-volatile solute. Dilute solutions having non-volatile solute. Second one. So it is not applicable if the solute dissociate or associate. Obviously, if the solute dissociate, associate, Raoult's law is not applicable. That means, so to apply the Raoult's law, solute should not dissociate, should not? It should not dissociate or associate. And third one is, to apply the Raoult's law, solute should not react with solvent. Chemically, solute and solvent should not react with each other. So therefore, third one is, solute should not chemically react with solvent. Right on. Limitations of Raoult's law. One, it is applicable for, one, it is applicable for dilute solutions having non-volatile solute. It is applicable for dilute solutions having non-volatile solute. Two, second limitation is, solute should neither dissociate, solute should neither dissociate nor associate. It means solute should not dissociate and should not associate. Okay, solute should neither dissociate nor associate. Third one, solute should not chemically react with, solute should not chemically react with solvent. Right, exactly similar we have studied Henry's law limitations. It is Raoult's law limitations. Okay. Now here onwards, very very important, classification of solutions. Right, classification of solutions based on Raoult's law. Classification of solutions, take down, right heading, based on Raoult's law. So based on Raoult's law, solutions are classified into two types, that are ideal and non-ideal solution. So first one is ideal solutions and second one is non-ideal solutions. So this classification is done based on the what? Raoult's law. So therefore, based on Raoult's law, solutions are classified into two types. One is a ideal solution, second one is non-ideal solutions. Then non-ideal solution further classified into two types. Solution showing positive deviation from Raoult's law. Again, they are classified into two types. Solutions showing positive deviation from Raoult's law, and B, solution showing negative deviation from Raoult's law. So there are again two types of non-ideal solutions. So let's study one by one in detail. So first one is ideal solutions. Okay, tell me, so what are ideal solution and what are the example and next characteristics? So ideal solution is the solution which obey Raoult's law at all the concentrations and temperature. The solution which obey Raoult's law at all concentrations and temperature is called what? Ideal solution. That means all ideal solutions obey Raoult's law. So therefore, what is the definition of ideal solution? The solution which obey Raoult's law at all concentrations and temperatures called ideal solutions. Okay, next, if the solution obey Raoult's law, it means which equation? Pa equal to xA into P naught A, then Pb equal to xB into P naught B, and P total is equals to Pa plus Pb. It means if the solution obey these three equations, then that solution is called what? Ideal solutions. Next, now in order to obey these three equations, in ideal solution, the intermolecular force of attraction between, let us take solvent and solute and solute solvent. Let us say first solute and solvent. It is a solute solvent. It is a solute solvent solvent. Then tell me the intermolecular force of attraction between these, whether equal or different?
Equal.
They should have equal intermolecular force of attraction. The intermolecular force of attraction between solute and solvent is equals to solute and solvent. Then usually, let us take, for example, if I represent solute and solvent with B and A. Okay, let us take, second important point is intermolecular force of attraction. So intermolecular force of attraction between solute, take for solvent, okay, solvent solute should be equal to solvent, it should be equal to solvent, it should be equal to solute. What is the meaning of this? It means if you take solvent is A and solute is B, solvent represented by A, solute represented by B, then the intermolecular force of attraction between AB, which is equals to what? AA, solvent, which is also equal to BB. It means, so solvent solute and solute, all three are having same intermolecular force of attraction. Due to same intermolecular force of attraction, so they have same, that means they can obey these three equations. Then what are the example for ideal solutions? Even questions based on examples also important. So what are the example, can you tell me anybody? Benzene plus toluene, chlorobenzene plus bromobenzene. Okay, see here, compounds have similar nature, like benzene, toluene, similar nature. Chlorobenzene, bromobenzene, similar in nature. Ethyl chloride plus ethyl bromide. So they also have similar nature, similar property. Next, carbon tetrachloride, silicon tetrachloride. Carbon is a 14th group, silicon is a 14th group. And N-hexane plus N-heptane are example for ideal solution. So these example given NCERT textbook. You remember only NCERT examples only, enough. There are many more, but remember NCERT examples, right? So next is characteristics of ideal solutions. Tell me, what are the characteristics of ideal solution? First characteristics, they obey Raoult's law. Yes or no? That's what they called ideal solution, right? They obey Raoult's law. And tell me, what is the Raoult's law? PA equal to XA into P naught A. PB equal to XB into P naught B. Then P total equal to PA plus PB. Actually, this P total is not Raoult's law. Which law it is? Dalton's law. According to Dalton's law. Okay? So therefore, these two are the Raoult's law equations. So they all these solutions obey Raoult's law. Next, what about their intermolecular force of attraction? The intermolecular force of attraction between solvent and solute is equals to solute solute and solvent solvent. So therefore, the intermolecular force of attraction AB, A is a solvent, B is a solute, which is equals to AA, which is also equal to BB. Next, then what about their delta V mixing? This is previous CET question. Tell me, delta V mixing is equals to zero. What is the meaning of delta V mixing? So delta V mixing means is a change in volume. Delta V is a change in volume. So change in volume equal to zero. Then how do you calculate change in volume? So change in volume is, let us take total volume, V total. V total equal to, can we write VA plus VB? Yes. The total volume of solution equal to sum of the volume of solvent and solute. Yes or no? Then, now what is a V, delta V? Delta V is total volume minus sum of the volume of solvent and solute. Now, so total, this is a change in volume. Change in volume equal to total volume minus sum of the volume. Now, this delta V is equals to zero. Tell me, when this delta V equal to zero? So delta V becomes zero when V total is equals to VA plus VB. The total volume of solution should be equal to sum of the volume of solvent and solute. How this is? For example, take a beaker, take 5 ml of solvent A. Okay, take the 5 ml of solvent A and take 5 ml of solute B. Mix these two. When you mix 5 ml of solvent, 5 ml of solute, what do you expect? 10 ml. If you get 10 ml, then tell me, if you get 10 ml, this V total equal to what? V total equal to 10 ml. Then VA equal to 5 plus 5. Then it is a 10, 10. Both are equal, no? It means substitute here. Delta V. In this case, what is the delta V? Delta V equal to 10 minus 10. Then delta V equal to 0. Isn't it? Now, suppose if you take 5 ml of solute, 5 ml of solvent, will get 10 ml only, no? Will you get 11 ml? Will you get 12 ml? Or 9 ml? You may get. But if you get only 10 ml, then only it is called what? Ideal solution. If you do not get 10 ml, that is called non-ideal solution. In case of non-ideal solution, it happens. If you take 5 ml A, 5 ml of B, we expect 10 ml. But sometime you may get 9 ml, less than 10. Sometime you may get more than 10, that is 11 ml. Such solutions are called non-ideal solution, so that we'll study later. So, but here in case of this ideal solution, the total volume of the solution must be equal to sum of the volume of solvent and solute. If you take 5 ml, 5 ml, you will get 10 ml only, not less than 10 and greater than 10. So therefore, if solution delta V equal to 0, then that is called what? Ideal solution. In all ideal solution, delta V mixing is always equal to 0. Okay, next. What about delta V, delta H mixing? So delta H mixing is also equal to 0. So delta H, it is a change in enthalpy. So change in enthalpy 0, it means heat neither released nor absorbed. There is no heat change. Heat change is 0. It means neither endothermic nor exothermic, if delta H equal to 0. Next, one more important point is delta P is also equal to 0. This is, you might have not studied in PU level, but it is also 0. How? What is the delta P and how delta P become 0? See, let us see first what is the delta P. We know that PA equal to XA into P naught A. Right? So PA equal to XA into P naught A. Right? Then delta P is equals to PA minus XA into P naught A. Right? The partial pressure of A minus, it is also partial pressure of A only, no? Because the product of mole fraction of A and P naught A is also nothing but partial pressure of A only. Therefore, so delta P is nothing but PA minus XA into P naught A, which is called delta P. Now tell me, in case of ideal solution, so here PA equal to what? XA into P naught A. Since PA equal to XA into P naught A, then what is the delta P?
Zero.
If these two are values are same, since these two values are same, delta P become 0. If the delta P is 0, that is the ideal solution. Right? In all ideal solution, delta P become 0. If it is a non-ideal solution, you will not get 0. Right? Next, another important characteristic is, usually ideal solution, they do not form azeotropic mixture. We will study next class later. So azeotropic mixture, they do not form azeotropic mixture, whereas in case of non-ideal solution, they form azeotropic mixture. And next is, in case of ideal solution, whether solute is react with solvent or do not react with solvent. Solute should not react with solvent, right? Yes or no? That is nothing but application of, that is limitation of what? Raoult's law. Since it obey Raoult's law, right? Solute should not react with solvent, and solute should not dissociate or associate in the solvent. So these are all characteristics of ideal solutions. Okay, so on this question may come like this: which of the following is true in ideal solution, or which of the following is a false in ideal solution? That's one question. But in 2019 question paper, they have given directly, neat question paper, example given, which of the following is the ideal solution, right? So NCERT textbook examples only important. So only these examples given textbook, remember these example. Other than these example, all are non-ideal solutions. Take one question. Which of the following true for ideal solution? Which of the following is true for ideal solution? A. Delta 1. A, write like this. PA minus XA into P naught A equal to 0. B, delta H is neither exo or endothermic. C, total volume of solution is equals to sum of the volume of solvent and solute. D, all. So therefore option can be given indirectly. It is need not to be give always delta P. We know delta V mixing equal to 0. Delta V mixing equal to 0. Then why delta V mixing equal to 0? Because of this, no. That's what indirect option may be given. So therefore V total should be equal to VA plus VB. Similarly PA minus XA into P naught A equal to 0. That is also possible. That means all are possible. Okay. Next. Which of the following is not a ideal solution? Which of the following is not a ideal solution? 1. N hexane plus N heptane B, benzene plus toluene C, ethyl alcohol plus water D, carbon tetrachloride plus silicon tetrachloride. Which is not? Yes. So ethyl alcohol water is a not a ideal solution. Okay, so this is one kind of question. Okay, next is write non-ideal solutions. Non-ideal solutions. Rajeshwari, so what is the definition of non-ideal solution? The solution which do not obey Raoult's law. Okay, take parallelly. The solution which do not obey Raoult's law at all the concentrations and temperature. Barkole, take parallelly. Right. The solution which do not obey Raoult's law at all the concentrations and temperature called non-ideal solution. Okay, for non-ideal solution, can we write PA is not equal to XA into P naught A? Yes, they do not obey equation. Next, can we write PB is also not equal to XB into P naught B? And of course, P total also not equal to PA plus PB, right? So these two are the Raoult's law. It is a Dalton's law of partial pressure equation. So therefore, all the non-ideal solution, they do not obey Raoult's law. Next, second point. Then what about intermolecular force of attraction between solvent and solute? In case of ideal solution, solvent and solute intermolecular force of attraction equal to solvent-solvent and solute-solute. They have equal intermolecular force of attraction. But here, the intermolecular force of attraction between solvent solute is not equal to solvent-solvent. And which is also not equal to solute-solute. That is, if the solvent represented with A, solute is B. So AB intermolecular force of attraction not equal to AA, which is not equal to BB. They do not have equal intermolecular force of attraction. It means they do not have equal intermolecular force of attraction. It may be the intermolecular force of attraction between AB may be greater than AA, may be less than AA, but it is not equal to AB. That is AA and BB. So therefore, they are not equal. They may be less or they may be greater. Next is example. So example for non-ideal solution, we have in non-ideal solution there are two categories. One is non-ideal solution showing positive deviation. Second one is showing negative deviation. All positive deviation, negative deviation comes under this non-ideal solution. Okay, we will write separately what are the positive and negative deviation. That's what you need not write here. Example. Other than ideal solution, you can write. If you want to remember, other than ideal solution, all are non-ideal. Okay. Then next is, what are the characteristics of non-ideal solutions? Come on, tell me fast. What are the characteristics? One, of course, they do not obey. Rolle's law. Okay. Next, intermolecular force of attraction between AB is not equal to AA, which is not equal to BB. Next, three. So what about delta V mixing? So what is the delta V mixing? Change in volume. How do you calculate change in volume? Total volume minus sum of the volume of solvent and solute. Okay. So delta V mixing is not equal to zero. Next, fourth characteristic is delta H mixing is not equal to zero. Next, what about delta P is not equal to zero. Next, whether they form azeotropy mixture or not? Yes. Ideal solution do not form, but these can form. So they form azeotropic mixture. And sixth one, in case of non-ideal solution, solute should not dissociate, should not associate, and solute should not chemically react with solvent. It is a property of actually solution. Okay, so therefore the last two properties are same. Solute should not dissociate or associate, and last one is solute should not chemically react with solvent. Right? So there should not be a chemical reaction between solute and solvent. So it is a quite opposite to the ideal solutions. Differences between ideal and non-ideal solution. Take one side. Ideal solutions non-ideal solutions. Come on. So tell me the differences. One, they obey Rolle's law. Here, do not obey Rolle's law. Next, intermolecular force of attraction, solvent and solute equal to solvent solvent, which is equals to solute solute. Here intermolecular force of attraction between solute solvent not equal to solvent solvent, which is not equal to solute solute. Next, delta V mixing equal to zero. Here delta V mixing is not equal to zero. Next, delta H mixing zero, delta H mixing not equal to zero, delta P equal to zero. What is the delta P? Low change in nothing but what? Lowering of vapor. Yesterday was right? No. Lowering of vapor pressure, delta P. So lowering of vapor pressure is zero. That means there is no lowering of vapor pressure. Here is delta P not equal to zero. There will be a lowering of vapor pressure. Next. Yeah, do not form azeotropic mixture. Azeotropic mixture also called azeotropes. Here they form azeotropes or azeotropic mixtures. Okay, so these are the some important differences between ideal and non-ideal solutions. Okay, any other difference? Delta P. What is the delta P? P naught A minus? No. Lowering. That is you are telling lowering of. XA into P naught A also called what? P only. If there is a pure solvent? That only. It is a pure solvent, you know. If it is a pure solvent, P naught A into XA equal to P or P naught. Wait, I'll tell you. Non-ideal solutions classified into two types. One or A. Non-ideal solutions showing positive deviation from Rolle's law. Non-ideal solution showing positive deviation from Rolle's law. One is positive deviation, so one more we have negative deviation. See, if you are able to understand what is the meaning of positive deviation, negative deviation, all the things are very simple. You just remember only one point. See, in positive deviation, there is a positive deviation. When there is a positive deviation, it is a possible. We know that if it is a PA equal to XA into P naught A, this is the ideal solution, right? Yes or no? Solution obey Rolle's law. Right, this is ideal solution. PA equal to XA, PA equal to XA into P naught A. Suppose, if PA is not equal to XA into P naught A, that is called what? Non-ideal. But in positive deviation, there is a vapor pressure of pure solvent or vapor pressure of solvent is more than the vapor pressure of vapor pressure calculated by Rolle's law. The vapor pressure of any component is greater than the vapor pressure calculated by the Rolle's law. It means this vapor pressure of pure solvent is greater than the vapor pressure calculated by Raoult's law, then it is called positive deviation. In positive deviation, this vapor pressure will be more when compared to the calculated vapor pressure. So PA is greater than XA. In case of negative deviation, what happens? In case of negative deviation, this PA will be less. The vapor pressure of PA is less compared to the what? XA into calculated vapor pressure, XA into P naught A. So therefore, now tell me, what is the definition of solution showing positive deviation? The solution in which the vapor pressure of pure solvent or vapor pressure of any component is greater than the vapor pressure calculated by Raoult's law. So therefore, take the definition. The solution in which the vapor pressure of any component, the solution in which the vapor pressure of any component is greater than the vapor pressure calculated by Raoult's law, right? So the vapor pressure of any component is greater than the vapor pressure calculated by Raoult's law. It means, what is the equation? So same thing we have written, PA is greater than XA into P naught A, then PB is also greater than XB into P naught B, even P total also greater than PA plus PB. So this is in positive deviation. Okay, now tell me, the partial vapor pressure of component is greater than the vapor pressure calculated by the Raoult's law. It means partial vapor pressure is more. When the partial vapor pressure is more, for example, you take A and B component, AA component and BB. Now, when the vapor pressure is more, vapor pressure become more when the solute and solvent undergo vaporization easily. Yes or no? If the solute and solvent undergo vaporization easily, for example, you take, this is a AB component. Okay. If this AB component, this AB bond is broken easily, it undergo vaporization, it form vapor, then vapor pressure will be more. So therefore, the vapor pressure of component or solution become more when AB will have weak intermolecular force of attraction. If they have weak intermolecular force of attraction, A and B undergo easily vaporization. Here vapor molecule increases, obviously vapor pressure is increases. It means, to get PA greater than XA P naught A, PB greater than XB P naught B, what should be the intermolecular forces? The intermolecular force of attraction between AB should be weaker than AA and BB. Isn't it? Suppose, if the intermolecular force of attraction between AB is very strong, if AB is very strong, can A and B undergo vaporization easily? They cannot undergo vaporization easily. It means vaporization decreases, vapor pressure is decreases. In that case, what happened? PA is less than XA into P naught A. PB is less than XB into P naught B. Right? But in this case, so if they have weak intermolecular force of attraction, they undergo vaporization. As a result, vapor pressure is increases. So therefore, tell me, now in this solution, in these solutions, intermolecular force of attraction, take down, intermolecular force of attraction between AB weaker than AA and BB. So in this solution, intermolecular force of attraction between AB is weaker than A and BB. As a result, As a result, molecules of AB undergo. As a result, molecules of A and B undergo vaporization easily. As a result, molecules of A and B undergo vaporization easily, and vapor pressure is increases. Okay. Next is characteristics. So what are the characteristics of these solutions? One, first characteristic is they do not obey Raoult's law, that is PA is greater than XA into P naught A, PB is greater than XB into P naught B, P total is greater than PA plus PB. Okay, second one, once again we write, they have weak intermolecular force of attractions between AB. They have weak intermolecular force of attraction between AB compared to A and BB. Now tell me, what about delta V mixing? So delta V mixing is less than 0 or greater than 0? Why? It is greater than 0. Why? So what is the meaning of delta V mixing greater than 0? We know that delta V is equals to total volume of the solution, V total, total volume of solution minus sum of the volume of solute and solvent, right? For example, let us take 5 ml of solvent, 5 ml of solute. Tell me, when you mix 5 ml of solvent and 5 ml solute, what do we expect? We expect 10 ml. But will you get 10 ml here? No. If you get 10 ml, that is called ideal. You will not get 10 ml here. What do you get? You will get in case of this, you will get more than 10 ml, not less than, more than 10 ml. Yes or no? See, if it is more than 10 ml, then only you will get delta V mixing greater than 0. Suppose, let us take V is equals to, VA equal to 5 ml and VB equal to 5 ml. Okay. Then, if you get V total is equals to 11 ml, now tell me, what is the delta V? So, 11 minus 10, it means 1. Delta V mixing equal to 1. It is greater than 0. Yes or no? Therefore, in this solution, the total volume of solution must be greater than the sum of the volume of solute and solvent. If you add 5 ml solvent, 5 ml solute, you will get not 10 ml. It should be greater than 10 ml. It may be 10.1, 10.2, it may be 11, 12, depends on intermolecular forces. Yes or no? You can understand here. In this solution, intermolecular forces of attraction between AB is weaker. See, due to weak intermolecular force of attraction, what happened? A and B, they move away from each other. When they move away from each other, their total volume is increases. Yes or no? See, let us add 5 ml here. 5 ml A, 5 ml B. When we add 5 ml A, 5 ml B, A having beginning very strong intermolecular force of attraction. Due to strong intermolecular force of attraction, it occupying 5 ml, it occupying 5 ml. But when these two mixed, then what do you get? AB. In between AB, there is a weak intermolecular force of attraction. Due to weak intermolecular force of attraction, A and B move away from each other. Due to weak intermolecular force of attraction. Therefore, they occupy more volume. When they occupy more volume, that means total volume of solution is more compared to sum of the volume of solute and solvent and solute. It is possible. Generally, we think that when we add 5 ml, 5 ml, we are supposed to get 10 ml. No, you may get greater than 10 ml, you may get less than 10 ml also. That is in case of non-ideal solution. If you get greater than 10 ml, that is called positive deviation. That's what it's called, positive deviation. Right? It is greater than 10 ml, that is delta V mixing should be greater than 0. So this is greater than 0 because of weak intermolecular force of attraction. Then similarly, delta H mixing also, delta H mixing also greater than 0. Tell me, delta H mixing greater than 0, positive or negative? Delta H mixing must be positive. So that means it is a endothermic process. It is a endothermic process. Okay, next. What about delta P? Delta P also be a greater than 0, yes or no? Why? Again, it is same because of weak intermolecular force of attraction. Due to weak intermolecular force of attraction between A and B, they can undergo vaporization easily. They undergo vaporization easily, their vapor pressure is increases. Their vapor pressure is more compared to AA and BB. Right? Because AB having weak intermolecular force of attraction. So therefore, due to weak intermolecular force of attraction between A and B, the vapor pressure of AB is more compared to AA and BB. Suppose the vapor pressure of, question is like this, the vapor pressure of A, solvent A equal to, vapor pressure of solvent A is equals to, let us take 600 mm of mercury, and the vapor pressure of B is equals to 480 mm of mercury. Then what is the vapor pressure of solution AB in positive deviation? Whether, what is the sum of this? 1080 mm, option A, or less than 1080, C greater than 1080, D none of the above. You need not to calculate. If it is a positive deviation, in positive deviation delta P must be greater. So that means it may be more than 1080 mm of mercury because of weak intermolecular force of attractions. Okay, like this logical question can be expected. Next, so therefore here, can we write P1 is greater than X1 into P01, P2 is greater than X2 into P02, nothing but PA, PB. Next, yeah, very important is they form azeotropic mixture. Now question is, they form which kind of azeotropic? There are two type of azeotropic. One, minimum boiling, maximum boiling. Okay, there are two type of azeotropic mixtures. One is a minimum boiling azeotropic mixture, second one is maximum. Then tell me, they form which type of azeotropic mixture? Again, you understand this, they have more vapor pressure, right? P1 is greater than X1 into P01. That means the vapor pressure of this solution is greater than the vapor pressure calculated by the Raoult's law. They have more vapor pressure. When the vapor pressure increases, what happens boiling point? We know that boiling point is inversely proportional to vapor pressure. You have to remember. And whereas freezing point is directly proportional to vapor pressure. So boiling point is inversely proportional to vapor pressure. Now tell me, since boiling point is inversely proportional to vapor pressure, here vapor pressure is increases, therefore boiling point is decreases. Therefore they form minimum boiling azeotrope. That's it. these are the some important characteristics. And examples, examples given in textbook, ethyl alcohol plus water. Next, methyl alcohol plus water. Okay, and some more example given. Do it. Take down till here. Right. So take these examples. Ethyl alcohol plus water, methyl alcohol water, acetone plus ethyl alcohol, acetone plus CS2, acetone plus benzene, carbon tetrachloride, benzene, carbon tetrachloride, chloroform, carbon tetrachloride, toluene. Okay, third and question taken first. Take down question. The vapor pressure of pure solvent, the vapor pressure of pure solvent, pure liquid, not solvent, pure liquids A and B are, the vapor pressure of pure liquids A and B are 600 mm of mercury, comma, 480 mm of mercury respectively. If these liquids forms, if these liquid forms minimum boiling azeotrope, if these liquids forms minimum boiling azeotrope, the vapor pressure of solution is minimum boiling azeotrope. The vapor pressure of solution is A, option A, 1080 mm of mercury, B, less than 1080 mm of mercury, option C, more than 1080 mm of mercury, none of the above. Okay, so again question is given indirectly, right? There are two liquids A and B, they mixed and their vapor pressures are given. These are the two liquids, pure liquids. The vapor pressure of A given 600 mm and B given 480 mm of mercury, and said that they form the minimum boiling azeotrope. It means you need to understand minimum boiling azeotrope is possible when positive deviation. Very good. When they show positive deviation. If they show positive deviation, the total vapor pressure must be more than the sum of the partial vapor pressures. That's it. Okay. Therefore, it's more than 1080 mm of mercury. Okay. Next. Solution showing negative deviation from Raoult's law. Solutions showing negative deviation from Raoult's law. Tell me. Now tell me, what is the definition of solution showing negative deviation? The solution whose vapor pressure is less than the vapor pressure calculated by Raoult's law. Right, so therefore the solution, take down, द सोल्यूशन हुज वेपर प्रेशर इज लेस देन द वेपर प्रेशर कैलकुलेटेड बाय रोल्स लॉ. ओके, इट मीन्स पी ए इज लेस देन एक्स ए इंटू पी नॉट ए. नेक्स्ट पी बी इज लेस देन एक्स बी इंटू पी नॉट बी. इवन पी टोटल ऑल्सो लेस देन पी ए प्लस पी बी. ओके, दैट मीन्स द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ दिस सोल्यूशन इज लेस. देन इन ऑर्डर टू गेट लेस वेपर प्रेशर, वेदर द अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन सोल्यूट एंड सॉल्वेंट शुड बी वेरी स्ट्रांग और वेरी वीक. It should be very strong. That means the force of attraction between solute and solvent must be greater than the solvent and solute. If they have strong intermolecular force of attraction between AB, if the intermolecular force of attraction between AB is a stronger, what happened? This AB, this bond cannot be broken easily. It means they cannot easily undergo vaporization and their vapor pressure is not increases much. So therefore, second important point is they have strong intermolecular force of attraction between AB. So they have strong intermolecular force of attraction between AB compared to compared to AA and BB. Okay, next is characteristics. Okay, come on, tell me, what are the characteristics of this solution? One, do not obey. Do not obey Raoult's law. Take down. That is, if they do not obey Raoult's law, that means this equation can be written. So that is PA is greater than XA into P naught A. PB is greater than, sorry, less than XA, XB into P naught B. And P total also less than PA plus PB. Okay, next, second characteristic, intermolecular force of attraction. Intermolecular force of attraction between AB stronger than AA and BB. Next, what about delta V mixing? It should be less than 0. Now tell me, delta V mixing less than 0, what is the meaning of this? We know that, delta V is equals to total volume minus sum of the volume of solvent and solute. In order to get it is a less compared to this, then among VT and VA plus VB, which should be greater? VA plus VB should be greater. Suppose if we add 5 ml A plus 5 ml B, then tell me what should be the total amount, total volume? It should be less than 10. It may be 9 or 8 or something. If it is 9 ml, suppose, then 9 minus 10, it is equals to minus 1. It means, so when we add 5 ml solvent, 5 ml solute, in solution, if you get less than 10 ml, that is a negative deviation. Is it possible? Not possible. If it is not possible, why we study? It looks like magic. Like add 5 ml water, 5 ml something, other solvent. If it is less than 10 ml, of course, it looks magic, but there is a chemistry behind that. That is possible, right? So therefore, so here, the total volume of solution VT must be less than VA plus VB, then only this condition is possible. Okay, so take this. Delta V mixing is less than 0, or V total must be less than VA plus VB. Next, fourth characteristic. What about delta H mixing? So delta H mixing also be less than 0. So fourth one, delta H mixing less than 0. So it is less than 0 means it should be negative. Yes, it is a negative. This process is a exothermic. It means when solute and solvent is added, energy will be released. Exothermic. Next, fifth one, what about delta P? It is also less than 0. Delta P less than 0, it means what? We know that delta P equal to PA minus XA into P naught A. It means among PA and XA into P naught A, which should be greater? XA into P naught A should be greater. It means PA should be less than XA into P naught A, then this condition is possible. Next, last one is, they form azeotropic mixture. But the question is, they form which type of azeotropic? There are two type of azeotropic, minimum boiling, maximum boiling. So as we know that boiling point is inversely proportional to vapor pressure. Freezing point is? Directly, okay. So boiling point is inversely proportional to vapor pressure. Here vapor pressure decreases or increases? Vapor pressure is decreases. Like for example, the solute and solvent. The solvent, let us take A and B. The vapor pressure of solvent is 400 mm of mercury, and B is, let us take 200 mm of mercury. Okay. Then when solute and solvent are mixed equal proportion, then the resultant vapor pressure of solution PT equal to something, it is a 500 mm of mercury. Tell me, it is less than this, no? The total pressure is less than the sum of the solvent and solute vapor pressures. That is nothing but they show negative deviation. In negative deviation, the total vapor pressure of solution must be less. If the total vapor pressure is less, boiling point will be more. So therefore, they form the maximum boiling azeotropic. Maximum boiling azeotropic mixture. Right? They form maximum boiling azeotropic mixture. Okay, so these are the example for solution showing negative deviation. HCl water, HNO3 water. Remember like this, acid plus water. Okay, when acid is mixed with water, or water is added to acid, so they form the now strong intermolecular force of attraction. That is a hydrogen bonding. Due to strong intermolecular force of attraction, their vaporization is decreases. That means vapor pressure is decreases. That means, remember this, in all these examples, so the relation or attraction between two components is very, very strong. It may be due to generally hydrogen bonding. Okay. So these are the example for negative deviation. Now, right, differences between non-ideal solution showing positive deviation and negative deviation. Differences between non-ideal solution showing positive and negative deviation. Will you write it, differences?
Yes, sir.
Write fast. Take one side, non-ideal solutions showing positive deviation. In other side, negative deviation. Okay, so whatever we have studied, right, all the examples, all the characteristics side by side.